100.
Magic Man, Paulie Malignaggi in the house. Sean Porter, Adrian Granados, Wilder Stavern. Let's talk about the heavyweight division real quick. Wilder weighed in at super lean 220. We were talking behind the scenes a little bit. Joshua's a big 254. Just keeps on putting more and more muscle. How does that edge out?
It edges out. Then we'll see how Deontay fills out. But I think Deontay has to be at his best weight. Deontay has to be at his best weight. If that's a little bit lighter, then he's got to do it at that weight. I mean, do I think the smaller weight helps Joshua be the bigger man? And can he translate that into an advantage? He can. But I think a nimble, quick Deontay also has advantages as well. So we'll see. Because a nimble, quick Deontay still packs that big punch of power. Regardless of what he weighs, he's knocking out all these guys. So I think he remains relevant and dangerous, and you have to acknowledge that.
Does the weight differential in the heavyweight division matter as much? Because Mike Tyson was taking down dudes at the same weight, 220, and he was a small heavyweight.
If a guy is big enough and knows how to use that size, knows how to use that strength, yeah, sure. I think Tyson Fury being 6'10 and 6'9 made a big difference for him. I really think it made a big difference for him. You get in a clinch with that guy, you can't even move him. You can't do it. You got on the outside and he's all corner, you're messing up the timing. So you want to get back close to him, but in close to him, you can't move. You just get to a clinch and you can't even move the guy, you know? So I do think size to a degree does start to matter in the heavyweight division, but of course you got to know how to do it. You got to know how to use that.
Wilder gets a lot of flack. They say he fights bums, etc. Now, you know, people are saying
he fights bums. I think everybody keeps failing drug tests, and I don't think that's his fault.
Yeah, exactly. People are saying Joshua's making excuses, that he's getting real, like, political, saying, oh, we're going to do it this way, and the belts, and mandatories.
I spoke to Joshua last week, and he said, you know, it's not that it's political. It's that, you know, I work really hard to get these world titles, you know, and so I'm not just going to give them up. You know, if I have mandatory duties, I have to take care of those first. You know, I want to fight Wilder. I want to fight everybody, but I worked really hard to get to these titles. I finally got them. I'm not just ready to give them up when I just got them, you know, and I understand that from his perspective as well. So I understand both sides. I think both sides in the end want to make the fight, and that's the one.
You were in the ring with Sean Porter once upon a time, foreseeing that he gets past Granados, rematch with Keith Thurman. How does that look?
Well, I think the winner of this fight in general obviously has a lot of opportunities and possibilities. You know, it's a big walkaway fight. If Porter wins, you look for Keith Thurman, you look for Errol Spence, you look for all those kind of fighters. I think if Granados wins, he probably can go back to 140 pounds and have some big numbers in there too. You know, make his name a little bit bigger.
Why is nobody saying Spence's name? Terrence Crawford wants Thurman, Sean Porter wants Thurman, and
I think people start to think guys are slipping and they get a little older and maybe stay out of the ring. Keith has a lot of stuff going on out of the ring. He just got married, a lot of things going on. So people automatically have this perception like maybe he's not as hungry anymore. You know, Errol looks like a young lion. I don't think people should sleep on Keith. I don't think Keith has given anybody any reason to sleep on him. I think he's kept looking good in his performances. What he does outside the ring doesn't necessarily translate to what he does inside the ring. I don't think you can call Keith Thurman a distracted fighter until you finally start seeing him distracted inside the ring. That's why we haven't seen that.
Obviously, this is just sparring, but Sean told me that he sparred with Errol Spence. He obviously fought Keith Thurman, but that he says Keith Thurman hits harder than Errol Spence. Is that from the eyeball test? Do you think that's accurate?
When a guy can punch, a guy can punch. I don't know who's punching harder at that point. It doesn't really matter. If you can punch, you can punch. It's like Berman and Deontay. They both can punch. It doesn't matter who punches harder. If one lands on the chin, the other one's going to sleep. Mm. It doesn't matter. At a certain point, a certain amount of power is power. You know?
Now, people are saying that Canelo is kind of making Triple G wait because they're talking about him fighting the winner of Saunders and Lemieux. Is that the right way to go? Should, you know?
Yeah, I don't think anybody should be surprised about that. It took them long enough to get Canelo in the ring with Golovkin to begin with. I think the fact that he got away scot-free without taking the L, now he can say, hell, everybody, I already gave you that what you wanted, now screw you, I'm leaving. See, everybody that defended this draw, this bullshit draw, now should be ashamed of themselves. Because had Canelo lost, he would have given him the rematch, he would have got the rematch right away. But instead, Canelo got the draw, so now he has a chance to cop out of it. And I don't want to be disrespectful, because Canelo's fought a lot of great fights, and he's been a great fighter. But you wanted to see the rematch, now you're not going to get the rematch because of the draw. If the right guy would have got the decision in the first fight, you would get that rematch.
So many people retired, most notably Andre Ward. I just want to know real quick, last, Paulie Malignaggi's top pound for pound fighter.
Right now, it's hard. I mean, it's hard. Lomachenko, you have Redondo, you have, I don't know, man.
No Terrence Crawford in there?
Terrence Crawford in there is obviously in the conversation.
There's no guy who's clear cut above everybody else?
It's hard. I mean, it's pound for pound will always be subjective, and it's not going to stop. You know?
All right.
There's no fact to that answer, you know?
Let everybody know, man. Brooklyn to the World podcast.
We just did it now. And catch me on social media at Paul Malignaggi.